Hello learners, welcome back to the C programming lecture series. I, Kirti Sharma, am working as an assistant professor in St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management, Gurugram. So today in this lecture series, we will discuss the introductory part of the functions. So introduction to the functions, advantages of the functions, then different types of the functions that you can use, like user-defined functions and predefined functions. Then parameters, how to use the parameters in the functions. Then how to call a function in a program. So reasons to use the functions, different types of the functions with the respect to the arguments and return type. So each and everything we will discuss one by one. So this is most important topic from exam point of view. So stay tuned with the lecture to get the clarity in better way. So let's start with the introductory part. So first of all, what do you mean by function? A function is a self-contained block of code. It's a very important line actually. So self-contained block of code that performs a particular task. What it mean? Like self-contained block, which a block which contains the code according to the need. Right, according to the need. So nothing is as unrelevant. So whatever will be there in the block of the statements, that will be relevant, and that is the most summarized form of the coding. So for a particular to perform a particular task, right? So we have the two types of the function category: library functions, that means predefined function that are library present in the C library. Next is user defined functions. User defined functions indicate like user or programmer or developer, you can make the code, make the function according to the need and can use throughout the program. So like scanf, printf, sqrt, these are the functions that are already available in the C library. User can directly use those functions. That's why these functions are called as library functions. What do you mean by user defined? I've already told you, like main is a function, in which this main keyword, the name of the function is predefined only, but the functionality, whatever is there in the block of the main function, is defined by the user itself. So the function is the functionality of this function is a user defined here. Okay, so what about next? The use of the user defined function allows a large program to broke down into the smaller pieces. Why? If you have a larger program, so it's difficult to execute that particular program and understand it in better manner. So for that purpose, we just broke down the program, large program, into the smaller one, and then make the self-contained components, each of which has some unique and identifiable task or purpose. So that will make our task or our work easier to perform on the C program. So there are various advantages of the user defined functions. Of course there will be, because it's all about the user. So user, it depends on the need of the user. Like here you can say developer or programmer who is doing the programming, according to the need they can make the special function, and you use the can use the functionality of that function in the programming, right? So first is repetition. Repetition means like if a function may be used to avoid the rewriting the set of same statements within the same program. I have already told you, if you want to execute the one statement 10 times, for that purpose if we are writing it once and we are applying the loop, then it will execute 10 times, right? So same thing here for a function. If you want to perform a task in the generalized form, so you are making a general formula and you are executing that particular statement again and again, like wherever you will call that particular function, then only it will call, right? So there is a difference of course between the loops and the function. Loop can have, like I'm writing here for loop. So for loop will act as, if it come out of this loop, it will never go again, right? That is the main functionality of the loops. If your program come out of the for loop, then it will not come go back to this, right? So here in the functions, if you are calling a function, This is a representation of the function. Wherever throughout the program you call this particular function with the name of that function, it will work in the same manner. Okay, that is the difference between loop and function. Next is universal use. What do you mean by universal use? If you have created one function once, then any number of times you can use that particular function throughout the program. That is the universal use. Next one is debugging. Debugging becomes very simpler. It makes very simpler after using the function. If you are using the function, it executes one time, then in debugging of the same function become easy task. Next is modularity. A program for complex program can be developed into the modules fashion. Individual modules you can make for a complicated program. You can divide the program into the sub-modules and you execution of the submodules will takes place individually, and after that you will get the combined result as the resultant at last. Next is memory. Of course, memory efficiency matters here. Function use the less memory. If you will use the a function for a number of statements, then teamwork is matter here, because you are dividing the complex programs into the submodules and all those submodules are working independently. If teamwork will be there, then only coordination between the submodules can exist in a better way, right? So can be handled in a better way if teamwork is good. So readability should be there. If you are executing the separate modules, then after also readability and understandability must exist in better manner, because at last we have to combine the result in order to give the finalized output of that particular program. Reusability is that you can reuse that particular function again and again wherever you required by calling the function. Okay, so code optimization, of course we are optimizing the code by putting the functions. So once you create the function, and after that wherever you want you can use that particular function, right, in a better way. So it reduces the coding number of lines in the code. So that's why code optimization also takes place, because of function. So here you can see user defined function also. So it's about the syntax of the function, how to write the function. First you have to write the function type. That means it is a return type. Here you have to write the data type of the function, like int, void. Okay, f name is function name, whatever the name of the function you want to give, you can. Then argument list will be there, some arguments will be there. Argument declaration part, you can define it here. Within the curly braces you can define local variables, number of statements that you want to execute. At last you have to return something. It depends on the f type, function type. If you are using the void, then no need to return anything. If you are using int and float or any other data type, then you have to return some expression over here. Okay, so here is one example is given here. Void hello, it is printing the hello function, right? So whenever you call this particular function, it will print the same. So how you can call the function, we will discuss this in particular this example. The first statement of the function must be the function definition. First you have to define the function, then only you can use that function. Specifying the return type, name, formal arguments, what it means. Of course, if you have no, if no name is given to you, nobody can call you, right? So there should be a specific naming of you, like in your childhood you have given the name, and throughout your life journey you will call by the same name, right? So that's the amazing thing here also in the function. First you have to define the function, you have to give the definition of the function, name, data type and all. Then after you can use that function throughout the lifetime of that function, that means throughout the program. Because if you are coming out of the program, you are executing some another program, then its lifetime is over, that previous one program function. So return type void, no need to return anything special here. If you are returning like int, I'm taking here an example, square is a function name that I'm taking here, a is the here argument that we are passing. I'm declaring it as int a. Next we are declaring here some local variables, int s, s equals to a into a, right? That is the square only. And in last, we are returning the integer value, whatever we are getting here in s. Why is it so? Because I have taken here int as a data type. So it's important to return. So you can return either a cross a as a expression, or you can take the resultant in the local variable s, and then you can return the s here, right? Or you can write as like this also, square int a you are declaring. It may possible you are using the like declaration and calling using part simultaneously here, at least like this, and it will return this one also. So these are the two ways to write the program in order to calculate the square of the function, right? So it is a user defined function example here. Next, your types of the function. There are two types of the function that we have already discussed. So these are the functions that belong to the library of the C. Scanf, printf, these, their functionalities are already defined in the C library that we use by calling, by including the C header files. Next, definition given by the programmer, user defined. In user defined, user programmer create that functions create the functionality of those functions and can use throughout the function. So throughout the program, so if the big programs are exist to reduce the complexity, it optimizes the code also. So it was all about the types. Then how to declare a function. I have already told you, first you have to declare a function, then after you can use it, right? Now we will see step by step things like how to declare the function and how to use the functions. The basic syntax is, first you have to write the return type, function name, data type, parameters, whatever you want here, any number of parameters you can write, and within the blocks of the function you have to write the statements whatever you want to execute. After that, you have some return value here. So in a C function, may or may not return it may or may not return any value, because if you will use void, then no need to return anything. Okay, so first we are taking example without returning value. That means functions with no argument and no return type. So we are seeing the definition types of the function with respect to the arguments and return type. If there is no any argument and no any return type, like void itself, nothing is inside, then this is the one type of the function. Okay, next one is, if you want to return any value from the function, you need to use any data type like int, long. So I'm taking here like data type, but no any here return type is here, but no any parameter I'm taking here. Okay, so that means return 10, we are returning the integer value only, but without any parameter. So with return type, without any parameter. So next, in this example, like if we have float data type, in the same thing, return type is there, but no any parameter here. It's up to you, you want to insert here or not. So if you are using float, then you have to return the decimal point values here with the help of return. Okay, if you are using int, then integer value should be there. Okay, so next one is parameters in C. So what it's mean, if up to now we have seen the two things, without return type, that means we have used void, and with return type, and for both of them we have never taken the parameters, right? Here we are taking the parameters. So first thing that we will take here, like first thing that you have to note it down, the parameters or arguments are also known as formal arguments. Okay, so we will discuss this thing also, formal, actual, arguments, parameters. So before that, we are seeing like if zero parameters are there, then it's okay. No any return type, no any parameter. Next, we have one parameter. If return type is there with one parameter, we have passed n as a parameter over here, right? So next is like to find the cube return, this expression with two parameters. So here we have two parameters with the int, like int return type, int a, int b. There are the two parameters that we are passing in the function name add, and it's returning some expression that will give you some integer value, right? So next thing, we have discussed the how to declare a function. Now we have to call a function. After a declaration, you have to call it wherever you want. Like wherever to you want to apply the function, you have to call it. So what is the way to call the function? If a function returns any value, then you need to call function to get the value returned from the function. If you are taking void data type in return as a return function, then nothing is there to return. So you have to use this syntax like you have to use this syntax like variable name is there, very function name and arguments, right? So variable here is, the variable is not mandatory actually. If you want, it's optional. If you want directly to execute this thing, then you can use. So if you I'm just taking it here for to make this task easy, like to call these things again and again, you have to just call this particular variable only. So no need at all. If you don't want, if you want to skip it, then you can. Next is function name. Of course, the name of the function that you have to give in at the time of the declaration. Then arguments that while C function, when you will call as a actual arguments. So there are two types of argument, actual and formal arguments. If you are giving the, like we will see it later. Before that, we have example to call a function. Like we have to write this type. Like nothing was, the data type was there during declaration of the hello function. So I have taken hello itself without any data type and I have written it. Nothing is there as an argument here. Why? Because you have taken it without argument. So int value, we are taking the variables here in order to call the functions. Like whatever is the return here, whatever is it is returning, it will store into the variable itself. Same here, add 10, 20. So we are calling here add function with two parameters. That means after addition, whatever will be the return type, so it will save the particular type in value in the value 1 variable. Okay. So next is a well performed example, like with the output, like how you can execute the functions with no return type, without any return type. So we have taken here void. So you can declare the function anywhere, wherever you want to declare the function throughout the program, you can declare anywhere. There is no any boundary. Like before the main you have to declare either, or after the main you have to declare, but there is, this definition should not be inside the main, right? So void hello is there function without any data type, it is printing hello C programming. In main function, what we are doing here, we are calling a function, like writing the hello this three times. I am calling the same function. So it will print this statement three times over here, and at last we are returning zero, because nothing is as an integer we have to return from the program. So it is compulsory to return the integer type. So that's why return is by default returning the zero here. Okay. So next is function with return type. Previously we seen the without return type. This one is return type that we have taken int in order to find the cube. So cube is the function name. Int n is the one parameter that we are passing here. This is the way to calculate and return. Wherever this function name will call, it will return that particular result, whatever it is getting here over this block of the functions. So int main, int main we are declaring two variables, result1 and result2. In result1 we are calling the cube function with the value of n is 2. So it is important to pass the value of parameter here if it is mentioned during the definition. Any parameter is mentioned here during the execution, then you have to put the value for the same. So 2 and 3, two times you have called this. So for the 2, what will be the answer for what it will return? 2 into 2 into 2, that will return 8. So result 1 consists of 8 value. Next, result 2, cube 3. So 3 cube is 3 into 3 into 3, that means 27. That means in memory space, 2 bytes, result 2 is slotted here, then its value will be 27. So after all, we are printing the resultant values of the result 1 and result 2 only. So it will return 8 and 27, and last it will return 0. So it was all about like how to call up, how to use the function, definition of the function, how to call a function with return type and without return type. So next is the reasons are there to use the functions, why we have to use these functions. Actually, many programmers requires that a specific function is repeated many number of times instead of writing the function code again and again. So it makes our task easier. By writing a single function, you can access that same function again and again as many number of times. It will minimize the memory also, like memory space, and execution speed will also get fast. So avoid the writing redundancy of the program code will also avoid here. So instructions you do not need to write again and again. So it make the easy our tasks
And testing and correcting errors will also become easy, like to find the errors in the localized or corrected it. So if anything is divided into the blocks, or anything is divided into the submodules, and submodules is having some functionalities to perform, in between those block of the statements, whatever your task performing, it become easy to find the errors in the particular block of the function itself. So throughout the program, if 1000, 10,000 lines of the codes are there, if you are tracing one by one error for the error code, or it will be difficult to make this task. If you are subdividing, if you have submodules, then it will become easy to check it out for the errors also. So there are the types of functions that we have discussed, like functions without any argument, without any return type, right? That means void you have used here. No return type, same here, void is there, but argument is there. Like we have already discussed, one argument is there. With argument, like argument could be 1, 2, 3 or any number. Then with return type and without return type, the same. So order and type of the actual and formal parameter arguments in the function call should be matched. So whatever is the type and order, like we will discuss about the actual and formal, then after you can get the better understanding about it. So first of all, here, what do you mean by actual and formal arguments? Before that, it is important to know the difference between parameters and arguments. So frequently you seen that in C programming, both these words are used interchangeably, but there is a problem. You cannot use both of the things as the same. So there is a little bit difference. A parameter is a variable in the declaration of the function, right? While you are declaring a function, you are using the parameter. Whatever you are declaring the variables in the parameter, in the function as a parameter, that particular variable is known as a parameter itself during declaration part. But an argument is called the actual value of this variable that gets passed to function. So whatever is the value that you will pass, that will be the argument. So here is an example to get the better thing, understand this particular thing. We have declared here int type two variables num1 and num2 with some constant values. And I have declared here function over here. So I call the function sum. Like this variable, in the variable sum, what function? Add function, where we have two parameters, because like you have to decide it, you are declaring it or calling it. So here it's a calling time. So during the calling, you have some argument here. So these are also known as actual parameters. So actual parameters, during we are you calling here, then you are using the actual parameters where you have to pass the values, right? And here we are defining the add function, and here we are writing x, y. What it means, during the definition, whatever you have, it will act as the formal parameters. Just think a single example here. If you are inside your home, if you are inside your home, then how you will treat whatever you are original, right? That means actual. What you are actual, that you will behave, right? If you are going outside, then you will behave formal. So if you are calling the function in the body of the main function, right? In the body of the main function, inside the home, main is your home, whatever you have to perform inside the main only in the C program. So consider the block of the main code as your home. So whatever it, this function will behave, it will be the actual parameter, whatever will be there as a parameter. But outside it, wherever you have given the definition and wherever you are defining it, so that will be considered as a formal parameter. Okay, I hope it is clear. And next one is, there is a difference between actual and formal parameters. So actual parameters, we have discussed, that used inside the main function where you have to pass the values. In this example, the num1 num2 value is 25 and 47, that you have to pass over here whenever you will call this. The values of num1 and num2 will be there with the add function, right? And then it will go
to the definition of the add function. What should it need to perform? So it will do the cross check by seeing the num1 num2 value, and it will come here to the definition of the add here, right? So 20, it will do the addition of the 25 and 47. The values will return over here, like for value x it will become 25 and y will become 47. So actual parameters where we have passed original values, and formal parameters that have syntax but no values are the original. Whatever the values are here, that are passed by the actual parameters only. So these are whatever the thing you have here, it's not you, not its own. So he has it has taken from the actual parameters. That's why it will behave for the same as the formal. Okay, so whenever it will return the value, it will give the resultant to the program. So actual parameter, the parameters, they appear in the function call. When you are calling the function in the main function, it will behave as actual parameters. Where you are appearing function declaration, like formal parameters will appear where you are giving the definition of the function out of the main, right? Then which actual parameters are mentioned in the function, in function calling, that you have already mentioned, and here mentioned in the definition of the function called dummy. So dummy variables we have taken, like example, we have taken x and y as a dummy variables here as a parameter, formal parameters. The value originality will depends upon the function call time only. Whatever the variables you are using, it depends on that particular time only. So these are the actual values that can that call to the function, and these are the just to hold the values of, sent by the calling function. So they will perform the actually, and x and y will handle the only hold the values whatever is sent by the calling function. So they will behave actually, but they are they will just hold the values and perform the task and return it. Okay, so there is no storage the permanently for the variables. It can be returned as a constant expression. So it may possible you can write like 6, 9, a comma b. It's up to the need. So formal parameters are created when the function created and destroyed when the function end. So within the function their lifetime exists, formal parameters. That means when you are coming out of the definition of the main function, then the scope of these x and y variable will over. You can, if you will call it outside, it will give you the garbage value because its lifetime is in between the block of the function only. Okay, so it was all about the parameters, function. So one more thing, just giving the recap about the arguments and parameters. When you will pass the values, that means actual parameters, right? Actual parameters. When you pass the values to the parameters during the calling of the function, that is known as argument also. That is known as argument also, as well as actual parameters. But when you are declaring the parameters during the function definition, right, then it will called as a parameter, formal parameters. What it mean, like parameter having the two type, formal and actual, right? And argument, that is the actual parameters are the arguments. So parameters and arguments you can see as like this. So parameter is of two types, argument is a subset of the parameter. The value or the actual parameters that you are passing, that you are calling during the inside the main function is also known as argument here. So parameter, inside the parameter there exists the argument as a actual parameter. Whenever you call the value or whenever you call the function with the values inside the main function. So it was all about the introductory part of the functions. In next lecture we will do continue with the unit 3 and the concept of the functions itself. So stay tuned with the lectures. Thank you. Have a nice day.